It is said that John Jacob Astor, Benjamin Guggenheim, and Isidore Strauss were on the Titanic to return home so they can oppose the Federal Reserve Act. These three, along with J.P. Morgan, were the richest, most powerful men in the world. The four men had the net worth of almost $300 million, or over $7.5 billion today. So let's say that these three that died were not coming home to oppose the Federal Reserve Act. Let's say that they were for it. Then the control would be in too many hands. So whether they were for or against the central banking system, it doesn't even matter. They were, at the minimum, major competition.
Imagine a world that has become so deformed and twisted that up is down, down is up, black is white, white is black, war is peace and peace is war. This is the reality we are living in. And who is the big deceiver? Who turns the cross upside down?
What have you done to its eyes?
He has his father's eyes.
What are you talking about, guys? Eyes are normal. What have you done to him, you maniac?
Satan is his father, not Guy. He came up from hell and begat a son of mortal woman. Hail Satan!
Hail Satan! Satan is...
In 1968, Roman Polanski made the film Rosemary's Baby, where a struggling actor has to sacrifice his own wife to Satan for success, a practice that has become the real-life norm in Hollywood ever since. Roman Polanski even puts his own name, Roman, on the satanic neighbor, meaning the Roman as a Roman citizen or soldier out of satanic Saturnian Rome. The Roman Empire out of the Vatican that owns the central banking system and hijacked humanity out of England have always worshipped Satan or the planet Saturn, and it's not by chance that Hollywood have been sucking up to the hand feeding it for the last century. And in this deformed reality, factual history has taken refuge in the big fantasy stories of our century.
Step into light.
Your reputation precedes you, O Smaug. You have no equal on this earth.
The darkness is coming.
Thank you. Tower of the Three Rings is ended. The time has come for the dominion of men.
I'm glad to be with you, Samwise Gamgee.
Farewell. I pray for peace.